Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. In this video I'll be explaining you about deterioration of stones and also how to avoid the decay or deterioration of stones. Okay, so stones which are generally with exposed surface or with exposed face are generally acted upon by various atmospheric and external agencies which cause this decaying. So let's get into detail one by one. What are the main causes of deterioration? Means what are the main agents causing the decaying or deterioration of stones? First one is alternate dryness and wetness. See, generally how does a stone become wet? Generally stone becomes wet by some agencies like rain, frost, dew, etc. So when this wet surface will become dry with the help of sunlight or sunshine. So what is happening? Alternatively, the surface is becoming wet once and it is becoming dried once. So it is found that the stones which are subjected to such alternative wetness and dryness are wearing out very quickly, are decaying very quickly. The second cause is frost. So generally in hill stations or in very, very cold places, what will happen? There will be some moisture present in the atmosphere. And whatever moisture is present in the atmosphere, it will be deposited in the pores of the stone. So at freezing point, automatically this moisture will freeze, and by this process what will happen? It expands in volume, therefore the stone will start splitting up. So this is also one of the reason for decaying. Next we have impurities in atmosphere. What do you mean by impurities in atmosphere? Our atmosphere generally contains impurities, and this impurities will show very much bad effect on our stones. For example, if there is any town or any place which is having industries, so you can observe industry will be releasing a lot of gases or fumes containing acids and containing some chemicals, containing some impurities into the atmosphere. So what will happen once these impurities come and fall on the stone? Say suppose if your stones are made up of limestone, etc., like your marble or anything, limestone, what will happen? These impurities will start reacting with the carbonate inside the lime, and hence it starts again decaying. Next is living organisms. So living organisms like your worms, bacteria, what they do? They act upon the stone and they start eating away the stone, or they start deteriorating your stone. Next is movement of chemicals. Movement of chemicals means this sort of decaying or this agent is generally observed when stones of different varieties, say for example you have limestone and sandstone. So limestone is different in composition and sandstone is different in composition. But when you use these two stones one besides the other in the same structure, means if you observe this last diagram here, you can observe say if you observe this diagram, you can see two stones. You can see a brown color stone and a gray color stone. Means say suppose now take it as a limestone and a sandstone. So if you see both stones of different composition, they are placed one besides the other. So once you, and they are placed in the same wall, in the same structure. So what will happen is the chemicals which are formed by the action of atmospheric agencies on one variety of stone may move on to the other. And hence, therefore, it causes deterioration of the other also. So it's like transmission. Next is rainwater. How is rainwater affecting, or how is rainwater becoming the cause of decaying of stones? See, generally, the action of rainwater on decaying of stones is in two ways. One is physically and the next one is chemically. How rainwater is showing the physical effects? Means, just now we were talking about alternate dryness and wetness, correct? So what is happening? Rainwater or precipitation is falling on the surface of the stone. So automatically a stone is becoming wet, and this stone will slowly dry up when sunlight comes and falls on it. So this is showing physical action. So this such alternative wetness and dryness will result in splitting up of the stone or disintegration of the stone. This is our physical effect. Why? Because we have physical action. Then we have chemical effect created by rainwater. How rainwater is responsible for chemical attack? How means? So rainwater will start descending through the atmosphere, means it will be traveling through the atmosphere and then only it will touch the surface of the earth. So when it is traveling through the atmosphere has various types of gases. Say like if this rainwater will absorb carbon dioxide and it will absorb some hydrogen sulfide gas, etc., and some harmful gases which are present in the atmosphere, it will absorb, and again it will come down, it will condense, and it will fall as a rain. So these rain particles will have obviously this gas. So what will happen when this gas falls on the stones? It will affect the stones and it will result in decaying. This is the chemical action of rainwater. Next is temperature variation. What do you mean by temperature variation? Rise in temperature results in expansion of the stones. And similarly, fall in temperature or decrease in temperature results in contraction of the stones. So if this rise and fall of temperatures are frequent, very often, obviously your stone will be easily vulnerable for decaying. Next is vegetable growth. I think you observe in some of the parks or in some of the old buildings, from the compound wall somewhere you can see a small plant or tree coming out. So how is this vegetable growth? So that is a form of decaying, but how this vegetable growth is taking place? Generally, some trees and creepers will develop on the stone surface. The roots of these trees or creepers will be inside the joints between the stones. So one has to take care to fill the joints completely. Means if you are using stones to construct a wall, for example, you have to ensure that you are filling the gap between the two rocks or two stones. The joint is exactly filled. You are not leaving any pores inside. Okay. So once these roots start establishing from that pores, it will always try to keep, it will absorb the moisture from the atmosphere for its growth. So obviously your stone will be always under a damp condition. And hence, also these roots will try to expand, right? So finally causing decaying of your stone. Next is wind. How is wind responsible? Wind will generally contain fine particles of dust. And if this wind is blowing with very high velocity, what will happen? These particles will come and strike the stone with great velocity, and hence your stones will get decayed. And even wind allows the rainwater to enter into the pores of the stone with some force, and hence freezing and thawing will take place, and hence your stone starts splitting. So this is how these are all the causes or the agents which cause deterioration of stones or decaying of stones. So how should one avoid the deterioration? Initial selection, the first point, means initially whichever stones you are selecting, select the stones in such a way that they are compact, means they are very compact and hard in nature, and they are crystalline, and take care that they are not porous. Okay. Next, seasoning. What do you mean by seasoning? Seasoning means removing the moisture content from the stones. Generally, stones, whatever you get from quarrying, will have some moisture content in it, initial moisture content, that you call it as quarry sap. So you have to remove that. So then that process only is called as seasoning. So once you season the stones, it means that they are less vulnerable for the attack. Next, size. Obviously, size also plays a key role in this deterioration concept. Always prefer bigger size of stones, so that bigger size of stones are more durable than the smaller ones. Next is natural bed. See that placing on the natural bed, generally placing the rocks on the natural bed gives greater strength, and it is also detrimental to rain and frost. Means try to place rocks on the earth surface so that it will give good strength, it will be balanced well, and the attack of rain is also less. Surface finish. Always dress your stones in a proper way. Even you can observe in the last videos we were talking about dressing of the stones. See that your stones will be well dressed. They will be well cut into shapes. The surface of the stones will be well neatly done. They will be smooth finished. Especially, why? Because when you prefer smooth finished stones, what will happen is when the surface of the, generally you have to remember this point for stones when you are using it as using it for walls or any outside wall facings, etc. Why? Because that place only is getting affected by this precipitation and so on. So see that that surface is smooth enough. Why? Because when the surface of the stone is smooth, automatically the friction is very very less. So whatever particles are coming and falling onto it, they won't adhere to it. they start slipping away. So see that you prefer smooth finished and polished finish. That's why if you can see, in most of the cases for beautification purpose and outside places where they are using stone, polished stones will be used more. Next, coming to the workmanship, I was talking about vegetable growth. I told you the joints, whatever you are filling up, means you place two stones one besides the other, and the gap in between those two stones must be filled properly. Otherwise, we will be getting pore formation, and from that pores only all your vegetable growth etc. will take place. Okay, so no cavity should be present. Next, external rendering. You can just apply pointing. Likewise, I have told filling the joints and applying mortar in between the rocks or the stones, and also plastering the top surface can stop rainwater to penetrate or go into the stone. Next, proper maintenance. If generally maintenance is required when you are using stones for architectural things or for walls etc., you have to wash it timely, you have to remove the dust and dirt particles. Next is application of preservatives. So if you don't want to maintain it all the time, then you can just apply a preservative. Preservatives will generally stop the deterioration. Okay, so this is all about deterioration of stones or decaying of stones. Hope you understood the video. Thank you so much.